Support comes from the Missouri Forest Products Association, saluting Earth Day on April 22nd with an ongoing commitment to help offset carbon emissions with sustainable harvesting of Missouri forests. Details at choosewood.com.
Welcome to St. Louis on the Air. I'm Jim Kircher. The band Earth, Wind, and Fire has received multiple Grammy Awards and is enshrined in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The band is performing Sunday evening at Stifel Theatre in St. Louis. For more, here's arts and culture editor David Cazares.
Earth, Wind, and Fire may be best known for its hits from the late 1970s and early 80s, among them Let's Groove and September. But many fans of those songs may not know that the venerable ensemble was an African-American funk powerhouse. In the early 1970s, it built its reputation on musicianship, a captivating blend of R&B, jazz, soul, rock, and African rhythms, and positive messages. Joining me is drummer, percussionist, and singer Ralph Johnson, one of the three original members of Earth, Wind, and Fire. Ralph, it's nice to talk to you.
Well, thank you for having me.
Ralph, what do people want to hear when you go on stage with this group that's been around for so long?
I'll tell you exactly what they want to hear. They want to hear the hits. They want to hear the music that they grew up with, the music that made them feel good and still makes them feel good. But our set list consists of all the hits we ever put out, you know, and a few little extra goodies in there. You know, musically, it's a very diverse show.
You know, I've been listening to Earth, Wind, and Fire for decades now, but what strikes me is that, you know, the music that I grew up with and loved, the music that I heard on black radio, isn't the music that comes to mind for other people who discovered Earth, Wind, and Fire much later. Can you talk to me about those early days?
Well, you know, luckily we had a brilliant, brilliant leader, Maurice White, who came from a jazz background. He was also a session drummer in Chicago. And so his musical tastes were very diverse. At the age of, for us, he was 10 years older than us. So we were listening to a lot of different music, especially a lot of jazz, very progressive music. And that kind of carried over into what we were presenting on our records. You know, so a tune like Evil made, you know, total sense. A tune like Zanzibar or Help Them See the Light. You know, those were special songs. And we were able to branch out and explore exactly what we could do musically. And Maurice did a brilliant job of gathering all this talent together and then directing it, you know. So,
But that music that you played way back in the 70s had that signature sound of rhythm, musicianship, and the kalimba, or that African thumb piano. Let's listen to a bit of Evil, for example.
Okay.
This is Evil from the 1973 album, Head to the Sky. We're listening to Evil from 1973. Ralph, do you ever feel the tension between what you want to play and what the audience expects?
No, because when the audience shows up, they know what they're going to get. Our reputation precedes us. And so they know that they're going to get the hits, and we know that that's what they want to hear. And so we give them exactly what they want. It's going to be a feel-good show for 90 minutes.
You were talking about the late singer Maurice Wright, who founded the band. One of the things that he did was bring positive messages and a sense of mysticism to Earth, Wind, and Fire, the kind of thing that you don't hear often on the radio today. Now, we're not talking about socially conscious music, but the music that speaks to spirituality. How important was that to you?
Well, Maurice was all about spiritual growth. When we, as 20-year-olds, joined up with Maurice, I mean, he gave us certain books to read and talked to us about, you know, how to eat and all of that. And, you know, that spirituality was very much a part of what we were trying to convey. It was a message of love and of treating your fellow man with respect, you know, and keeping your head open, you know, to higher sources. And that's kind of the direction we went in. And we definitely tried to practice what we were preaching, you know. And still today, we're, you know, our minds are about, you know, a higher consciousness, you know.
So that would explain a song like Keep Your Head to the Sky.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, take the high road, you know, stay open, you know, and be respectful of others, you know, be compassionate, be a good listener, you know, because sometimes when people are talking to you, they're trying to tell you something, you know, outside of the obvious thing they're trying to tell you, you know, so you have to be able to read through that, you know.
Let's hear some of Keep Your Head to the Sky from the 1973 album, Head to the Sky. We're listening to the Earth, Wind, and Fire tune, Keep Your Head to the Sky. I'm talking to drummer Ralph Johnson. To me, the large African-American funk bands of that era is sort of like the end of the road for the big band and popular music before electronics and beatboxes. I mean, you could be a dance band, but you were pretty much a jazz rock fusion group that played danceable music, do you think?
I like that. I'll second that. You know, as I said, we were able to, we were fortunate enough to be able to explore other genres. At the same time, we were commercial enough to have acceptance, wide acceptance, you know, on pop radio. So it worked out, you know.
And then at the end of the 70s, we were fully in the disco era. And that brought almost to an end the long LPs with these multifaceted tracks. Did the disco sound interest you as a group?
No, one thing for sure. We were not interested in chasing trends. We had no intention of jumping into disco music. Our only offering during that period was Boogie Wonderland, which turned out to be a big record, which is still one of those tunes we do in our set list every night, you know. But we weren't, you know, that was kind of an accidental thing, you know. That tune was actually recorded on another group that Al McKay, our former guitar player, was producing. And Maurice heard it and said, this might be something that works for us, but I can assure you that we weren't trying to be a part of that whole disco situation, you know, because we weren't trend followers. We were just doing our music, you know?
Let's listen to some of Boogie Wonderland from the 1979 album Earth, Wind, and Fire with The Emotions. The Emotions were an all-woman vocal ensemble from Chicago. We're listening to Boogie Wonderland, one of Earth, Wind, and Fire's signature tunes, I'm talking to Ralph Johnson, a drummer, percussionist, and singer, who's one of the band's three original members. So the band is still touring with you, Philip Bailey, and bassist for Dean White, the only original members. Is it hard to keep going?
Not really. Not at all. We love what we do. We're still into it. We still enjoy being on stage. People still show up. We still sell out. So, no, it's not hard at all. And we're very organized out here on the road. It's run like a well-oiled machine.
And the spirit that Maurice White brought decades ago, is that still with you and something that you try to live up to?
Absolutely. No doubt about it. In fact, when we do, when we're doing That's the Way of the World, there is a black and white photo montage taking place behind us that has a lot of pictures of Maurice, a lot of pictures of us in the studio, some photos of us on stage, most of which were shot by Bruce Talaman, you know, who has a beautiful book out now on his photographic work from the 70s and the 80s of groups he shot, all R&B, you know.
So what else can people expect to hear and see at the show?
Well, look, at the end of the day, expect to have a good time because you're going to hear all of your favorite songs. And, you know, we will be in motion. We don't just stand around on stage. And the show is also very visual because of our visual displays behind us that take place while we're doing the show. So you will have a full night of entertainment by the time we finish.
All right. Well, Ralph, thank you very much for joining us. It's been a pleasure.
Okay, thank you.
Let's go out with a bit of September from The Best of Earth, Wind, and Fire, released in 1978.
That was Ralph Johnson of Earth, Wind, and Fire talking with St. Louis Public Radio editor David Cazares. Earth, Wind, and Fire is performing at St. Louis's Stifel Theatre this Sunday evening. This is St. Louis on the Air on St. Louis Public Radio, 90.7 KWMU.
Support comes from the Missouri Forest Products Association, saluting Earth Day on April 22nd with an ongoing commitment to help offset carbon emissions with sustainable harvesting of Missouri forests. Details at choosewood.com.
The Gateway brings you the day's news from the St. Louis region and across Missouri. It also includes stories from the Illinois side of the river and our Metro East reporter, Will Bauer.
In Alton, in Belleville, in East St. Louis, in Edwardsville, in Cahokia Heights, at Scott Air Force Base, I'm Will Bauer, St. Louis Public Radio.
Listen to reports from Will and all of our journalists weekdays on the Gateway, on the STLPR app, and wherever you get podcasts.